You've been on some tough assignments, Manon, but this time we're sending you to a rather dark place. This, of course, is Heinrich Himmler, Reichsführer of the SS. One of the more pitiful excuses for a human being that you'll ever encounter. Did you know he was a fertilizer salesman before the war? The quality of his current product isn't much different. He spent the last few years trying to sell Hitler on the creation of an official SS nation-state within Germany, establishing a royal class among the master race. Unfortunately, Himmler and the SS seem to be getting their way. The influence of this criminal organization has continued to grow as the war has gone on, to the point that they already have many trappings of an autonomous republic, including their own economy, political system, even their own army, the Waffen-SS, and now it seems their own capital. This is Wevelsburg. It's a castle in the Paderborn region near the town of Buren that Himmler has slowly been converting into his personal palace over the last couple of years. Since the SS has so much power and is responsible for so much within the Third Reich, we've decided to send you inside Wevelsburg to find out what exactly is going on in there. Steal whatever documents you can. They'll not only inform us of their current activities, but they also might prove to be valuable evidence at the inevitable war crimes tribunal for these deviants. Your transport leaves tomorrow morning at 0500 hours. Be extremely careful, Manon. We're not sure what you're going to encounter, except that it's most likely going to be bad.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. you can help me!
Thank you.
Here is the band of criminals that was the Axis leadership at the beginning of the war. Adolf Hitler, Führer of the Third Reich, the man who personifies true evil. Benito Mussolini, an incompetent thug who sold out his own people. Hermann Göring, the decadent Reich Marshal in charge of the Luftwaffe. And Heinrich Himmler, head of the Nazi SS who oversaw the greatest crimes against humanity. Himmler was a mentally unstable man who truly believed the crazy mythology that he and his fellow SS deviants created in their efforts to establish an independent state within Nazi Germany. Unfortunately, Himmler took his own life before he could be brought to trial, unlike Göring, who was convicted and sentenced to death at the Nuremberg War Crimes Tribunal, and who is no doubt spending eternity with the Reichsfriends.